I'd like to ask everybody, if you do have a cell phone, that you please turn it off. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we ask you to come. Father, Holy Spirit, and Jesus. Lord, we ask you to come like you came to that wedding in Cana. And we ask that you bless us with your presence. Amen. You may be seated. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and in the presence of these witnesses to join together Daniel and Stephanie in holy matrimony, which is an honorable state instituted of God, signifying unto us the mystical union which exists between Christ and his church, which holy estate Christ had born and beautified with his presence in Cana of Galilee. It is therefore not to be entered into unadvisedly, but reverently, discreetly, and in the fear of God. Into this holy estate these two persons now come to be joined. I require and charge you both, as you stand in the presence of God, before whom the secrets of all hearts are disclosed, that having duly considered the holy covenant you are about to make, you do now declare before this company your pledge of faith, each to the other. Be well assured that if these solemn vows are kept inviolate, as God's word demands, and if steadfastly you endeavor to do the will of your heavenly Father, God will bless your marriage and will grant you fulfillment in it and will establish your home in peace. Daniel, wilt thou have Stephanie to be thy wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Wilt thou love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all other, keep thee only unto her as long as you both shall live? Stephanie, wilt thou have Daniel to be thy wedded husband, to live together in holy state of matrimony? Wilt thou love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep thee only unto him so long as you both shall live? Who gives Stephanie to be married to Daniel?
Daniel and Stephanie, on this day, all days for you. The good news I have to share with you is God had kept a secret, his posture, his attitude, his heart for you. You both have accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. You're in Christ. And God's promise is this from Romans 5, 1 and 2. Therefore, having been justified in Jesus, we have peace with God. You can get married in peace with God. What a joy. And it goes on to say that we gain access by faith into the grace upon which now we stand. Your marriage is unusual to many, many marriages in the sense that you're coming to trust in Christ and his passionate love for you. His grace is uncontrollable from our side. We can't control his love. He just loves us. We stand upon his grace as our hear the promise of God for those in Christ. It comes out of Zephaniah 3:17. The Lord God is in the midst of you, and he is mighty. He will rejoice over you with singing. Now that throws me a little. You would think we're the ones to rejoice over him. He's rejoicing over you all with singing. He will rest in his love. So enter into this covenant with joy. Now, the God that created this whole thing we call marriage,
gives us his way to enter into it. And I want to give you just one biblical word, one biblical picture that I think is at the heart of what it means to be joined together in the covenant of marriage. In Genesis 2, 23 and 24, when God created this whole thing, woman and man after the image of God, he said, for this reason, a man would leave his father and his mother, and a woman would leave her father and her mother, and they'd be joined together, and the two shall become one flesh. It's that oneness that God is up to right now in this covenant. He's been up to it before now, and he'll be up to it every day in your marriage, making you one. One of the beautiful outcomes of that is, it says, and the two in the garden are naked and unashamed. He gives us a little more insight into what that means in Deuteronomy 6, 4. It says, the Lord says the Lord is one. This oneness, it's the same Hebrew word that he says he wants to make you all. He says it's about me and the child. I'm this way in myself in the Trinity. When God pulled down his skin and showed us his face in Jesus, he was asked about marriage. And Jesus said, he went right back to that verse. He said, wait a minute, you don't really understand because you want to talk to me about dissolving a marriage. He says, you don't really understand. God's never about dissolving a marriage. And he went right back to that verse. He said, for this reason, a man would leave his father and mother, and a woman would leave his, her father and mother, and the two should become one flesh. Hear the word of God. Jesus said, those whom God has joined together, let no person even think about something. Then to get a little more insight on this, Jesus says, the Father and I are one in John 10, 30. Then he, in his high priestly prayer, says, Father, I pray that you'll make Daniel and Stephanie, he actually prayed it for us all, one, as you and I are one. And lastly, when Paul starts talking about marriage, and he uses the analogy of Daniel loves Stephanie the way Christ loves us. Wow. Stephanie responded and loved Daniel the way the church responds and loves God. Paul goes back to the rationale, the Spirit of God through him, says, because after all, for this reason, a man would leave his father and mother, and a woman would leave her father and mother, and the two will come together and God will make it one. So I want to close this time by charging you on the authority of God's word. It is the will of God, Stephanie and Daniel, that you be one. Have nothing held back from one another. No secrets. Just like the Trinity. Wholehearted giving and receiving. Be one. Let Daniel and Stephanie become the one in your life. And Daniel, let Stephanie ever be the one in your life. Basically, I charge you today to repent of singleness. Never again think of your life apart from this oneness that God has put together. And lastly, this is, I believe, the miracle of grace that Jesus is going to work in your marriage is unique to a Christian marriage. Be one the way God has been one with us. He pulled on skin. He became present. He let us get our sick, sinful, broken, all that we are, good, bad, and ugly, hands on him. But he stayed present. And he stayed loving. And he stayed in a oneness with us.
To be reconciled, to have a covenant with him, a oneness.
Why not repent of your sinfulness and be joined with him? May the Lord bless deeply and richly this covenant as we have in your marriage. I, Daniel, take thee, Stephanie, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge thee my faith. I, Stephanie, take thee, Daniel, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy ordinance, and thereto I pledge thee my faith. The wedding ring is the outward and visible sign of an inward and spiritual grace, signifying to all the uniting of this man and this woman in holy matrimony through the Church of Jesus Christ our Lord. Let's pray. Bless, O Lord, the giving of these rings, that they who wear them may abide in thy peace and continue in thy favor through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In token and pledge of our constant faith and abiding love, with this ring I thee wed. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. In token and pledge of our constant faith and abiding love, with this ring I thee wed. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus said, "Do this in remembrance of me." This is the body of Christ and his blood shed for the remission of our sins. Amen. Lord, thank you for your body and your blood. Thank you for what you did for us. Amen. Thank you.
This is special because the day that I was converted, I'd never been to Wilmore before. And I came here in a pickup truck, and I sat back there in the very back pew on the far left and gave my heart to Jesus. And I've never regretted that day. Everything that I hold dear and good in my life came out of that moment back there. Let me say, today is a wonderful day. It's a very good day. And you know, the climax of the creation was the bringing together of a man and a woman. The first place that Jesus did a miracle was in a little town in someone's wedding. And you know, he referred to himself as the bridegroom and us as the bride. And the greatest wedding will be, we get to all participate in, will be the marriage supper of the Lamb on that great day. And so this is kind of a hallelujah chorus, a prelude to what's to come on that great day. For as much as Daniel and Stephanie have consented together in holy wedlock, and have witnessed the same before God in this company, and thereto have pledged their faith each to the other, and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let's pray. Eternal God and Creator and Preserver of all, Giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send thy blessing upon this man and woman, whom we bless in thy name, that they may surely perform and keep the vow and covenant between them made, and may ever grow in perfect love and peace together and live according to thy word. Look graciously upon them, that they may love, honor, cherish each other, and live together in faithfulness, in patience, in wisdom, and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing, a place of peace, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Daniel, you may kiss your bride. Friends and loved ones, I now give you Mr. and Mrs. Daniel Weir. Thank you. The other